He's the diving young gun set to take centre stage at the Commonwealth Games. They're kicking off next week.
And we love him. 20-year-old Sam Fricker is back on top of the block after his Olympic debut in Tokyo, and he joins us now on the couch in the studio. Sam Fricker, everyone! Yeah.
There he is. Oh, too kind, too
You've
kind.
You've lived the Olympic dream. You've ticked that off before your 21st birthday. Yeah. You're heading to Birmingham for the Com Games.
Yep.
Wow. How's that feel going into a Com Games now?
It's been so exciting. And to achieve my Olympic dream was something I can just tick off the bucket list. And this year has been hectic because I've ticked off nearly every major dream I've had in diving. We had the Olympics. I just flew back in from Hungary with the world champs where
wow.
I was happy we placed 10th in the world, which was better than the Olympics. So hopefully we can continue that trajectory straight into the Commonwealth Games.
That's
next year.
That's awesome. So when it comes to the preparation now for these Commonwealth Games, how much different are they in terms of when you were doing it for the Olympics leading up to Tokyo? Is it the same or...?
Ideally, it would have been, but because of all the COVID and things like that with the Olympics, training was a lot interrupted, not to mention all the comps were cancelled. So the good thing about the Commonwealth is we had nationals. We had, like, 6 months of solid training before nationals. Then we had Worlds, and we've had a few solid comps in a row, which has really helped, I reckon, with the mindset going into the Commonwealth. Because when you do compete, you get into that mindset of constantly competing, and you get used to those kind of stress and pressure, but the Olympics was kind of thrown in the deep end because we didn't have any of that preparation done.
Yeah, right on.
You have also, out of the pool, been blowing up on social media, young man. You have over 1 million followers and tens of millions of likes.
It is
this your
crazy
plan B if diving doesn't work out?
Yeah. Well, I reckon it's credited to the diving. Like, it's actually incredible. I've had nearly a billion views this year alone.
Yeah.
Wow.
Which is like... Yeah.
How's your mind?
It's been
And what are you
going to
do with that platform now?
Yeah. Well, I try to share good, positive messages. And same thing with, like, my passion for the environment. Like, I find a lot of young people want to go out and make a difference. And I feel like it's really positive to show on a good platform going out and doing good things, which is part of the reason I started my straw company, like, having an idea and going and doing something about it. Because I feel like when I was younger in school, I found people would come in and talk and it was a bit like kind of fear-mongering instead of the positivity being if you don't do this, this will happen, instead of, hey, we love the environment, which is why we want to do good things to protect it. And I feel like when you're told to do something, you're like, oh, I don't want to do that. But when it's like, I want to protect it because I love it, it's a different mindset and I find it more impactful.
That's mental. Speaking about being told what to do, keep saying you're a daredevil. And you do all these tricks. And like I said, it gets us involved in it. But you're obviously a professional athlete as well.
Where does this come into it? Enough. Yeah. Are you going to hurt yourself? You should be wrapped in cotton wool.
No, I've got too many stories about that. Number one, my mum hates it and my coaches hate it.
Oh, I bet.
I broke my ankle last year doing something like that and it was just after the Olympics.
Oh, my gosh.
Luckily. But I was doing flips and I broke it and I couldn't dive for months, which is why I strap it every day now, which you can see in my sometimes diving videos. But it's good fun, but I like to do this stuff. This is what I like to do in my free time.
We like to see it, but we want to see you do so well as well. I remember when we met you first before the Olympics and we went, this guy's going to be a star.
Yeah.
Just because you're so genuine, you've got the right head on you. And like I said, you get eyes on it. This is mental stuff. I want to see you do this all the time, but I also want to see you come home with trophies.
Thank you. It's a fine line because I got to make it like... Because, like, rock jumping, you guys might sit down and be like, hey, it's super dangerous, but I jump off stuff anyway for a living. So if the water's deep enough, the surface is okay, I feel like she'll be right.
Yeah. Don't try that at home, kids.
She should be right.
Sam, you're only 20. I reckon you've got, what, another 3-4 games in you at least?
Hopefully. I heard the 32.
2032 in Brisbane, that would be pretty amazing,
that'd
right?
Be incredible, yeah.
Oh, wow. We'd be here to cheer you on at least. That'd be pretty nice as well.
Could you imagine that one of those million followers that he has ends up going in 32?
That'd be incredible.
Just purely from watching your videos and kind of following, you're such a great kind of role model for people. I think what you do is fantastic.
And you're literally on the plane this afternoon?
Tomorrow afternoon. So I just came from training, back to training. We train in the morning, then on the plane.
Oh. Well, a couple of crazy jumps before you get on the plane and you'll be golden. Yeah.
We're so excited for you, Sam Fricker. Best of luck for the Com Games. I will be cheering you on from our lounge rooms and come back and see us when you come back.
Thank you for having me. And
of course, as always, you're awesome.
You're a legend.
Thank you.
We'll be keeping an eye on you.